relentless coverage asking the government why we are being mandated to link Aadhaar with mobile network service providers and banks, RBI issues clarification. The RBI has made it clear that they have not mandated linking Aadhaar with bank accounts. After Mirona's relentless coverage, the Reserve Bank of India has said that it hasn't issued any instruction to mandatorily link Aadhaar with their bank account. The banks, in the meantime, continue to threaten to suspend customers' accounts, failing to link Aadhaar with their bank account. With a clear answer from the RBI on linking Aadhaar with bank accounts, now citizens ask, why are banks still threatening to deactivate accounts if Aadhaar is not linked?
तो अपन तो उड़ीसा वाला का है, लेकिन यहाँ का जो आधार कार्ड है ना, अपना गांव का कार्ड तो इधर चलता भी नहीं है ज़्यादा करके, पर पैन कार्ड और लाइसेंस रहेगा तो चलता है।
It will be helpful when it is linked to Aadhaar with all the services, but I think so, it is not should be linked with everything.
वो बोल रहे हैं यार नहीं करेंगे तो अकाउंट बंद कर देंगे, तो I think पैन कार्ड है तो क्यों आधार कार्ड चाहिए, I think सब डिटेल्स है पैन कार्ड में।
I'm getting some messages from Vodafone that you link your Aadhaar card to your mobile services. There's no need, I don't think so. It should be get leaked because we have lots of securities over.
As the debate over Aadhaar rages in Ranchi, Jharkhand, an 11-year-old allegedly starved to death after the local public distribution office refused her ration because her Aadhaar card was not linked to ration card.
कितना दिन से राशन नहीं मिल रहा था?
भाग रहा है दिमाग से बता
6-7 महीने से राशन नहीं मिल रहा था.
पहले तो जिसके पास आधार कार्ड नहीं है उसका राशन कार्ड कट जाएगा, ऐसा नहीं है. अगर ऐसा किसी ने किया है तो गलत किया है. सुप्रीम कोर्ट का भी आदेश है कि जिसका आधार कार्ड नहीं है उसका आप आधार कार्ड बनवाइए.
The Aadhaar case is still being heard by the Supreme Court, but pressure is building to ensure citizens link their Aadhaar to their bank accounts and mobile numbers. Mirror now asks, why is the centre in such a hurry to impose Aadhaar? And more importantly, why are we getting continuous calls, messages and emails threatening deactivation if there is no order that makes linking Aadhaar compulsory? Mirror now report.
Well, we continue our coverage on this so-called mandatory linking of the Aadhaar card to our bank accounts because of the kind of phone calls and emails and messages we are receiving from our viewers. There are some very grave concerns. Point number one, like the message you're looking at on your screen, a lot of the banks are sending text messages to their customers and making phone calls to their customers saying things like, if you want your account to remain active, if you do not want your account to be deactivated or to avoid your account being frozen, link your Aadhaar. Now, one wonders under what ruling of the Supreme Court will the government have the authority to either freeze our accounts or deactivate our bank accounts? That's the first question. Secondly, if the RBI has come out quite clearly, and this is in response to an RTI request sent in by a journalist from the website called Money Life, the RBI has responded to the RTI saying the RBI has not received, has not put out any notice at all whatsoever mandating the linking of Aadhaar with bank accounts, which means that if this is not coming from the RBI, it's coming directly from the government of India. And finally, we must also remember that NRIs are not mandated or in most cases do not get Aadhaar cards because this is for residents, in which case what happens to the bank accounts that the NRIs are holding on the 31st of December? A lot of questions to answer, and we're going to also open up our phone lines so you can ask as many questions. I understand that several people have had trouble simply linking because of problems with the name, problems with the address, problems with the fingerprints. Call us and tell us the problems that you're facing. Joining me on the show this evening, Dr. Anupam Saraf, former CIO Pune City and Information Technology Advisor to Manohar Parikar in Goa. Gopal Krishna Agarwal, spokesperson with the BJP. Mohammed Khan, spokesperson with the Congress. D. Thomas Franco is the convener of the United Forum of Bank Unions, and he's the senior vice president of the All India Bank Officers Confederation. He'll join us through the course of this conversation. And Mr. Kailash Vasudev is an advocate with the Supreme Court. I welcome all of you to this conversation. I'm going to start with Gopal Krishna Agarwal. Gopal Agarwal, if the RBI has said very clearly in the response it has given to Money Life that it did not give any instruction for the linking of Aadhaar with bank accounts, then why are we doing it?
No, actually, in the same RTI, the RBI has also said that it is because of the notification by the government. It is not by the RBI. They only clarified that this requirement has not been set by, put up by RBI. It is by the government of India. And it is derived from the Aadhaar Act also, that the government wants this information. And in the KYC, I think there are several information which already are being given by the citizens or the clients of the bank to the bank. The KYC is an important issue where information is very much required for the controlling of the money laundering, other misuse of their bank accounts. Even international norms are now very strict on the KYC. Issues. We the banks, etc., where financial transactions of large magnitudes, etc., are involved, where there is money involved in regard to terrorism, drugs, etc., are being used by various agencies, illegal agencies. Banks' account are being used, and now at present also we have seen that the shell government has now deregistered around 2,10,000 companies. In which are assumed to be shell companies, which were only dormant companies and were being used for layering and prevention of money laundering, PMLA. So all these issues require that there has to be a transparency, more information with the banks with regard to the account holders. There is a government also needs information for tax compliance. There is very low tax compliance in the country, and with this low tax compliance, the government
cannot function properly. If all bank accounts require PAN cards, how will the submission of the Aadhaar card or the Aadhaar number change the government's ability to monitor tax compliance?
I tell you what happened is that the PAN, we earlier identity of the individual was sanctioned through the PAN card in the income tax return. But people have over the years manipulated and have been able to issue multiple PAN cards. And with multiple accounts, people try to this manipulate taxation laws. They camouflage their transaction, they camouflage, they evade tax, they launder money through various accounts. So government wants identification of accounts with individual. And at present, Aadhaar is the only unique identity which establishes single identity to the individual. Therefore, right. Government want to check whether people are misusing their bank account. At present, it's very easy to open multiple accounts with various branches, with various banks. Can have 10, 15. We have cases where more than 2,000 accounts are opened by the companies. So how to check this, control this, and how to control evade layering, money laundering, all these issues require an identity.
Mr. Agarwal, most of the text messages that we're receiving from our banks,
individual with the bank account.
Most of the text messages that we're receiving from our banks tell us that the account will either be frozen or deactivated if we do not link our Aadhaar numbers to our bank accounts. Under what authority will the government of India either freeze or deactivate bank accounts of citizens?
No, the bank have already several laws in the banking channel where if they find any suspicious transactions, where they find that the transaction,
if I don't link my Aadhaar to my bank account, will you deactivate my account? That's not a suspicious transaction. No. That's not a suspicious transaction. If I don't link Aadhaar to my bank account, do you have the authority to freeze my account?
Yes, definitely. Bank have the authority, and it is by the regulation, which is notification of the government, which says that Aadhaar is mandatory for filing of tax returns and linking your bank account. At present, the bank are only pursuing and following people to link their Aadhaar card to their bank account. They are neither closing their accounts, neither. Nobody is saying that the individual account will be closed, you cannot have multiple accounts, but your identity has to be established with the government authority, bank account with individual identity.
All right,
if
all right.
You
fair
have
enough.
Used
Let
multiple
me open...
PAN numbers, you are using multiple identities. That closure of multiple identity is must. And this time given by the government is up to 31st December. Later on, it will be decided what will happen. But at present, banks are pursuing people to link their Aadhaar to the bank.
All right.
Account.
Let me open this up to the rest of my panel. I'm going to start with Mr. Kailash Vasudev. Kailash Vasudev, first question. The RBI has not sent out the notifications. The government of India has. Secondly, does the government of India actually have the authority to freeze or deactivate our bank accounts for not linking this Aadhaar? And thirdly, when the matter is presented, it will be looked at by the Supreme Court. Why can the government actually hurry up in this manner and threaten people or manipulate people by saying that we'll freeze your accounts if you don't give in your Aadhaar numbers?
There is a strange dichotomy in this whole situation.
The Supreme Court is only looking after the government schemes. Government schemes linking to Aadhaar number.
Mr. Agarwal, the Supreme Court is looking at the new fundamental right to privacy and its implication on Aadhaar right now. That's what the Supreme Court is looking at, if I'm not mistaken. But Mr. Vasudev is a Supreme Court advocate. So let's ask him that question. Yes, Mr. Vasudev, go ahead.
That's correct.
Data of biometric data.
You see, this three-judge bench has referred the question of the Aadhaar to a larger bench. Nine judges have held that there is a certain amount of privacy which you have, which is absolutely sacrosanct and cannot be touched. The issue of the Aadhaar card linkage with privacy is now pending before a five-judge bench. When the notifications came under the Finance Act, amending and inserting Section 139AA into the Income Tax Act, that was challenged in the Supreme Court. And by the judgment of the court of three judges, they have pronounced that this judgment of theirs is subject to the outcome of the proceedings by the larger bench, which is dealing with Article 21 and privacy issues. Coming back to your specific positions, the Reserve Bank of India is entitled to issue directions to banks under the Banking Regulation Act for the purposes of managing and controlling accounts. The government is seeking to do this under the Aadhaar by issuing notifications. That's what the Reserve Bank says. The wider question which arises is that under the Aadhaar Act of 2016, which is essentially an act for the purposes of delivery of financial and other services and subsidiaries act to an individual citizen for the purposes of being identified. Even the act says under Section 7, if I'm not very mistaken, that if a person cannot present an Aadhaar card, there are other ways and means of identifying the person. In the recent incident in Jharkhand, which you've just mentioned, where a young child lost her life because she didn't have an Aadhaar card, the government has said the same thing, that yes, we could have given her the benefit of her food subsidies and the like, even if she didn't have an Aadhaar card. It's come too late. The child is gone. Now, on the third issue of the banks making it mandatory for the purposes of asking for your, know your customer accounts, or your telephone companies asking for it, there's a very major question which is now arising. Aadhaar is being used for the purposes of linking everything. Forget banking. It is also coming into your personal life. Your driving license needs it. Your permissions need it. Your passports need it. Everything needs it. Now, the Aadhaar system began somewhere in 2012 or 13, and then it came formalized into the Act of 2016. Do you realize that between the period 2012 to 2016, when the Aadhaar applications came in, they were based on identifications made under the... One second, please, let me finish. They were made on the basis of your PAN cards.
Yes.
So people who had 11 PAN cards were eventually disqualified by saying that this has happened. Now, the simple question which one should pose to the government and also to the authorities is, why were you not able to control and regulate all banking transactions or the bringing in of foreign exchange or returning the monies of the people under the applicable laws? If PAN cards have been abused, it is because of a failure of government. If you're using Aadhaar as a weapon, it is again because you're unable to find an alternate way out. There are so many ways and means of sorting out matters instead of putting everybody into the penance of the Aadhaar card. There's an issue here again. The Aadhaar card makes it mandatory that the data available, especially the core data, will not be passed on in the course of sharing data with other people. The Act provides for the sharing. The regulations also provide for the sharing. you may not take my core data for any purposes, but now if I go to the telephone company and say, look, I am Kailash Vasudev, in terms of your directions, I come to identify myself. I have got to stamp the biometric machine with my fingerprints. Now, if you're going to ask a telephone company to use a fingerprint for identification, the very purpose of the Aadhaar card is defeated, because you said that data can't be passed on. You've passed it on to the telephone companies for the registration. Isn't it a dichotomy? Your act prohibits it, you permit it. Your act does not give directions, you make it mandatory. There is something which is going strangely wrong in this whole working, and you are not bringing everybody within the scope of Aadhaar. If it is for the purpose of elimination of terrorism or anti-national activities and the like, you will not be able to do it through this Aadhaar system. The Aadhaar system is only for identification for financial and services. If you are going to make this Aadhaar mandatory, you are also going to be very careful in making sure it is not breached. The breaches have been reported. Jharkhand reported a couple of lakh identity cards being sold off. There had been instances for a colossal sum of 10 paisa, you are able to get Aadhaar data. We are not able to understand what is happening, and average citizen is at a loss to figure out what it is all about. It is contrary to the act.
Absolutely.
And wait for the Supreme Court.
Yes,
what's
I know Gopal Krishna Agarwal wants
again to
respond.
To consider this.
Briefly, can I come in?
Yes, Gopal Krishna, respond to that. Also tell me what happens to NRIs and what happens to their bank accounts.
The thing is, we are mixing two, three things.
Okay. What are we mixing?
Now, can I just briefly come in?
Yes, yes.
The issue is there, we are mixing two things. The first is the sharing of the Aadhaar number with the banking institutions, and sharing, the court is looking into sharing of biometric and other informations with the UDI authority. That these are two different things. When you are giving your Aadhaar number, nobody is sharing other information with the banking institutions. So these are two different things. Simply giving your Aadhaar number doesn't mean that your other personal informations have been shared with those institutions. Second thing is, even the court, if you see MP Sharma case and Karat Singh case,
it is.
Court had said that the right to privacy is not a fundamental right.
But now they're overruled now by nine
their
judges.
Own court laws. So it is a
sir, I'm sorry. This No. Mr. Agarwal, please. After the nine judges' judgment, you are wrong.
The technology is changing.
Mr. Agarwal, I'll let you respond. And Mr. Vasudev is right. There are a couple of things here. First of all, Mr. Agarwal, allow me to stop you, please. First of all, the Supreme Court is checking the constitutional validity of Aadhaar in the backdrop of our new fundamental right to privacy. So it's not just whether this data is going to that bank. The Supreme Court will look at all of it together. Point number one. Point number two, privacy is a fundamental right, as told to us by the largest bench in the Supreme Court. So to say that it's not a fundamental right, I'm sorry, you're completely wrong at this point. What we don't know is the constitutional validity of Aadhaar in light of this new fundamental right.
I'm quoting MP Sharma and Karat Singh case.
But none of that is valid after the latest judgment of the Supreme Court.
MP Sharma and Karat Singh case,
they have been overruled.
The court have said...
They have been
Supreme
overruled.
Court has said
they have been overruled by nine judges.
Right to privacy is not a fundamental right.
Mr. Agarwal, a nine-judge bench of the Supreme Court overrules anything else that was said before it. Nine judges of the Supreme Court, Mr. Agarwal. That is more than two judges, it's more than three judges, it's more than four judges. Nine judges. So the latest judgment that says privacy is a fundamental right is the most important one and the only valid one right now. So, but you still haven't answered my question. You still haven't answered my question about what happens to NRIs. But I do have Thomas Franco with us.
Biometric and other information with the authority.
No, but Gopal Krishna Agarwal, you must understand that our viewers right now are not showing concern about the fact that, maybe the telecom company will take my data or the bank will take my data. They are uncomfortable giving it to the government. People don't trust the government at this point. They don't trust the government to keep the data safe. They don't trust the government to use the data with integrity.
But linking bank account with Aadhaar has nothing to do with that, na?
Nothing to do with what?
That you challenge the Aadhaar authority.
There is a huge trust deficit vis-a-vis you and your actions.
Aadhaar number
and you have no one to blame but yourself for that.
Right. Let me bring in Anupam Saraf. Dr. Anupam Saraf, go ahead. What do you? I see several problems, like Kailash Vasudev very rightly pointed out. I see several problems with these arguments. Go ahead, Mr. Saraf.
So I think I would like to first ask three questions to Mr. Agarwal. First question is that which government authority actually certifies Aadhaar as a proof of identity, a proof of address, a proof of resident status, or even a proof of existence of an individual? If you go back to the statement of the
2016,
if you
Aadhaar
my dear sir, please look at your Aadhaar card. There is no government seal or stamp or signature of any person, unlike your passport and your driver's license. There is nobody who certifies, and UIDAI and the Finance Ministry under RTI have replied that there is no government official who actually certifies it as proof of anything. UIDAI has repeatedly said we are only an infrastructure to make data available and to allow data to be retrieved and stored. So there is no liability that they take of identifying anybody. So using it as a proof of anything is misgovernance. Second question I have of you is, who has audited the data of the Aadhaar database? If you look at the statement of R.S. Sharma, so the minister, IT minister, he has indicated that 34,000 enrollment officers were actually suspended for malpractices in enrollments. If you take that they were enrolling between 50 and 100 people per day for at least a year before they were caught, that amounts to between 45 to 90% of your database. So you have that many ghosts or frauds in the Aadhaar database. So your theory that you are going to clean up any database using Aadhaar just doesn't hold any water. Third question I have of you is that if you were to look back at the RBI's files, you will see that the RBI has constantly questioned the use of Aadhaar for KYC. It has repeatedly said that this does not fit into the PMLA, the Prevention of Money Laundering Act. This is against the Basel standards. This is against our extant guidelines for keeping customer records. eKYC does not leave any records with the bank about how the customer came about to be. Traditional KYC practices of RBI have international norms which have been followed throughout, and they have ensured that they keep track of customers for the lifetime of the customer. If you look at post-Aadhaar, the number of bank accounts in India have doubled from 44 crores to 88 yes. crores. If you look at that, that is not financial inclusion. If you look at the amount of deposits, they have grown from 66 lakh crores to 122 lakh crores in 5 years.
Right.
This is not something which actually indicates financial inclusion. It indicates that Aadhaar-linked bank accounts or accounts opened solely with Aadhaar are actually harboring black money. Right. And therefore, there needs to be a CBI investigation yes. into the entire affair.
That's right.
You cannot link more bank accounts with Aadhaar. It will be a national disaster. And this is something that has been pointed out repeatedly to everybody from the in the authorities, and they have not yet taken action. I think it is high time that we stop this Aadhaar linkage with anything.
Right. I want to bring in Mohammed Khan. Mohammed Khan of the Congress Party. Go ahead.
Yeah, Phil. Gopal bhai, main aapse teen char baatein kehna chahta hu. Sabse pehle to main ye kehna chahta hu, by use of your coercive and completely slipshod manner of implementation of the Aadhaar scheme, you have forever blemished what will undoubtedly what could have been a fantastic program. Sabse pehli baat, aapko anivary banane ki koi zarurat nahi thi. You had no reason to make it mandatory. You presented the scheme, you could have presented the policy and said to the people that this is such a beneficial alternative for you to receive your benefits under various schemes, that try it out and see for yourself that you benefit if you have an Aadhaar card. You did not do that. You forced it down everyone's throat. As Mr. Vasudev explained earlier, you tried to link it to things that had no rational basis. As I pointed out earlier in a debate on this issue, death certificates, railway tickets, things like marriage certificates, for which there's no reasonable differentia. There's no understanding as to what Aadhaar entails.
School
you
fees.
Are just trying to get a blanket connection going. And that begs the question as to what is your intention. The answer to that, whether you like it or not, is surveillance. It is not that you want to deliver these goods in a timely and efficient fashion. You want to keep everybody in some sort of a net where you can keep a tab on their activities, how they spend, where they travel, and so on and so forth. Number two, Gopal bhai, dekhe, let us take concrete examples. Right now, there are people suffering as a result of your decision to make Aadhaar mandatory. Whether it be PDS, rations, midday meal schemes, as the example of the little girl who passed away, Jharkhand mein jo bachche guzar gaye, unke misal aapke saamne hai. Your arrogance prevents you from
hospital
not only acknowledging
admissions.
That, but acting on it. And of course, pensions and midday meals are something that affect the poorest of the poor. Your hubris stands in the way of you acknowledging that these are problems. Please, Gopal bhai, take this up with your leaders. People are dying and these are the poorest of the poor. These are old people and young children who are directly affected. Finally, main aapse ek teesri baat kehna chahta hu. Dekhiye, the RBI is, as Mr. Vasudev rightly cited the Banking Regulation Act, to say that the RBI is the nodal department to issue notifications to banks, not the government of India. We tried this. Let me tell you, when the UPA introduced the Aadhaar scheme, we tried to bring about a notification to make it a KYC for banks. As another panelist pointed out, we were told we couldn't do that. So we had to approach the RBI, and the RBI issued a clarification that yes, among other things, an Aadhaar is sufficient as KYC for you to open a bank account. I don't know how you managed to sidestep that jurisdiction. I don't know who are the councils advising you on this, but that is a palpably bad move. Finally, this. Look, this RBI, and I must commend them on this, has been at variance with you on a number of issues. When you spoke about job creation at being at an all-time high, they came out with data to show that job creation is at a 12-year low. When Pradhan Mantri Modi ji stood atop the Red Fort and said 3 lakh crores will come back, the RBI 15 days later came and said, no, nothing of that sort. The number is far smaller, at 60,000 crores. Number three, when you announced that,
right.
So on, as in the point I'm trying to make is, RBI has undermined you at every stage, even with regard to your growth projections with regard to the GDP. I'll say this to you, Gopal bhai, take what the RBI is saying seriously. They know what they're talking about. Please, you have to understand. And you give examples.
I'm going to keep you on point. We're talking about Aadhaar, and I also want to point out, one of my viewers just sent us a message on inball.in. We're also being asked for Aadhaar to be linked to our mutual funds, to our LIC. We understand that LIC, the Life Insurance Corporation of India, has refused to take premiums on renewals of life insurance policies without the Aadhaar linkage. So people are being forced right now, in order to keep their life insurance going with the LIC, to actually link their Aadhaar card. Thomas Franco joins us, and he's the senior vice president of the All India Bank Officers Confederation.
But the government has not asked our mobile companies or the insurance companies to do this.
So why are they doing it then?
Government is only saying that the return PAN card and bank account.
Mr. Agarwal, we understand that the Department of Telecom has asked the
confusing debate that you are having.
Question here.
No. Mr. Agarwal, you're saying the government.
These kinds of to be clarified before you debate on these issues. First you clarify the issues, then you debate on them.
If the government has not asked, then stop these companies from asking.
What will happen?
Mr. Agarwal,
government has said under Aadhaar. No, let me answer.
You've not listened to the question.
Aadhaar Bill 2016, Clause 7 says that if you want a government subsidies or you want benefits from the government schemes, you have to quote Aadhaar with your bank account. That is one thing, and that is with regard to government benefits and subsidies. Second thing is the government
is
within its
law
has said that for income tax returns and bank account, you have to give your Aadhaar number. These are the only two things that the government is requiring, and they are within the law. The Aadhaar Bill 2016
clearly mandates
Clause 7 that if you want some of the benefits of the government.
Okay, Mr. Agarwal, now listen to my question. Mr. Agarwal, let's accept what you're saying. Mr. Agarwal, everybody calm down. Mr. Agarwal, You are actually telling me, Mr. Agarwal, let me ask the question, please. Let me do my job. Let me ask the question, please. Let me ask the question, please. You are actually telling me that the mutual fund companies...
But then the debate is being confused, huh?
No, the debate is not being confused. As soon as I'm allowed to ask my question, the debate will stop being confused. The debate is getting confused because nobody is allowing me to ask my question. How are the telecom companies, LIC, mutual funds, driver's license, school admission, on what authority are these people asking for our Aadhaar number if not mandated by the government? Shouldn't the government then crack down on this and say you have absolutely no right to ask for this sensitive information? Why is LIC doing it? Isn't LIC, at the end of the day, owned by the government? No, why is LIC being allowed to do this? Why are telecom companies being allowed to send us these messages if not by mandate of the government?
People should refuse to share that information.
I'm sorry, what?
Why isn't the UIDAI?
These are commercial organizations. If they are doing which is not mandated by the government, the customer should refuse. And then if they still don't allow them, they should have legal remedies.
How is the customer going to know?
Is doing which
Mr.
is not
Agarwal,
mandated
how will the
by
customer
the
know what is mandated by
power,
the government and what is
then
not?
Then the customer should refuse it.
Let's put up a message from one of the telecom companies.
I'm telling you it is not mandated by the government.
The telecom companies are sending out messages that read as mandated
even,
by the government of India.
Even just now, Food Minister Mr. Paswan said that even PDS, you are not compulsorily mandated to give your Aadhaar.
Okay. This is a message, Mr. Agarwal, this is a message from Vodafone. It says, dear customer, as per Government of India directives, you have to link your mobile number with your Aadhaar at the nearest Vodafone store. Now, on what authority is this private company called Vodafone sending out messages quoting the Government of India directive?
You ask them?
I ask
them. Why you are asking me? You ask the Airtel representative under what authority they are doing.
One very important thing. Can I just say very
So the government has no control over private companies that are allowed
you to
willy-nilly quote the government's directives?
As the Airtel company is saying this, the government has mandated. Can you assume like this? The Airtel
what is TRAI doing?
Like
what is the Department of Telecom doing?
By the government.
No, Mr. Agarwal. What is TRAI doing? What is the Department of Telecom doing? What is the DOT doing? Isn't
Everything
it their job to regulate this industry? What is the IRDA doing?
So you ask
what
the
is SEBI doing?
Representative.
What is the RBI doing? These are all regulatory authorities.
Can I say something?
RBI has clarified its position. Similarly, you are
on the basis of so you are saying. Okay,
isn't
so
it for
all right.
The government
so what Gopal Krishna Agarwal is saying, Mr. Kailash Vasudev, and I'm going to take this to Thomas Franco. Gopal Krishna Agarwal is telling us that every citizen needs to write right now an RTI application to TRAI, the Department of Telecom, to the IRDA, to SEBI, to the RBI, and ask.
No, I'm not saying this.
That's what you're saying. That's what you're saying.
They should
and we need to be asking. Is Vodafone allowed to ask me? Is LIC allowed to ask me? Is Birla Sun Life Mutual Fund allowed to ask me? And only if these regulatory authorities reply saying yes, only then give your Aadhaar card. Because apparently the regulatory authorities are completely useless in this country and there's nothing they can do. So Mr. Agarwal, you know for sure that the Department of Telecom and TRAI have not sent directives to the telecom companies mandating that they make this link. You know that for sure because you've just said so on national television.
Whether they have given the direction or not, it is for them to ask. I cannot answer that.
All right. Thomas Franco, thank you for waiting so patiently.
He's
the senior vice president of the All India Bankers Officers Confederation. Mr. Franco, help us understand this mandatory link of Aadhaar with our bank accounts. If it's not mandated by the RBI, then is it legal?
Well, I am General Secretary, All India Bank Officers Confederation.
Yes.
What has come from the RBI is saying that we have not said it is mandatory has come late. But it is RBI which has issued the circulars saying what kind of signatures we should take from the customers when they come to the bank. We get directions not only from the RBI but also from the Finance Ministry. On 7th September, we have written a letter to the Finance Minister objecting to these directions. on three grounds. One, the Supreme Court has said that it should not be made mandatory. Number two, the bankers, the officers who are authorizing it, they are not trained to do that. Number three, the government is not paying any compensation to the bank, which is already in trouble. So on these three grounds, we have requested the finance minister that please do not force these things on the bankers. But till date, we have not got any reply from him, neither from the IBA nor from the finance ministry. So what is happening today is some coercive methods are used unknowingly from the lower level bank officials who are orally given instruction that you make it mandatory. So they start sending some SMS. They ask customers who are coming to the branch to bring the Aadhaar, which is not correct. The corrective measure has to be taken at the finance ministry level as well as at the RBI level. This is my stand.
And Mr. Franco, so in your opinion, as a banker, as a bank officer, you believe that this demand for linking of Aadhaar with the bank accounts, given the fact that it has not come in writing to you from the RBI, is illegal, doesn't follow the rules?
It is. The finance ministry has written circulars, and based on that, the banks, individual banks, have issued circulars. So we cannot say that it is illegal. But what they are doing is against the directives of the Supreme Court.
And Mr. Franco, what we've been given to understand is that several customers of SBI, which is the largest bank in India, when they go to the ATM to withdraw money out of their own accounts, there is a pop-up demanding the link with the Aadhaar, without which they are not allowed to access their own cash. Is this constitutional, in your opinion?
It is because of the instructions given by the finance ministry to the bank, we have implemented that. It is the finance ministry which has to take the corrective measures. As I told, the Aadhaar linking should not be made mandatory as per the Supreme Court directive itself. And we have also moved the Supreme Court at a different level. Okay. Now, the finance ministry gives a circular, we have to follow. They are the owners of the bank. So when they give directive, we have to follow.
And do you believe, Mr. Franco, the directive that perhaps has been issued to the mutual fund companies, to LIC and to other insurance companies, demanding the Aadhaar linkage as well?
Yes.
Mr. Agarwal says it's not come from the government. Where could that have come from?
No, it has come from the finance ministry only.
My other question to you is, up until now,
LIC Officers Association.
Right, all of these accounts and investments were functioning on the PAN card system. The government is now of the opinion that the PAN card system is horribly compromised and can no longer be used to verify our bank accounts and for tax compliance. Do you agree?
I do agree.
You do agree? And do you believe that the Aadhaar system is foolproof?
Yes. It is not foolproof. There are many reports which have come that it is not foolproof.
We have opened more than 2,000 accounts.
Please repeat your answer, Mr. Franco.
And
you said it's not
foolproof. And they are using it for layering and money laundering.
Mr. Agarwal, one second. He hasn't finished his answer. Mr. Franco, please go ahead.
No. It is not secure. Already it has been proved in a case in Airtel. Somebody had hacked the account and they had transferred amount. Correct. And there are similar cases across the country in many cases. So definitely it is not foolproof.
So my question now is to Kailash Vasudev. Kailash Vasudev, if tomorrow I get a phone call from my bank saying you must do this link, and I refuse, quoting the Supreme Court, the fact that the matter is before the Supreme Court, is the bank allowed to freeze or close my account on the 31st of December?
No, it is not. It is not. It is not for two reasons. A, you have a valid account which you're operating. B, there is no allegation that your account is a fraudulent account. Till such time as it is not proved to be a fraudulent account, no one can stop you from operating and owning your own money. I have a bit of a caveat here, which the gentleman from the Banks Association was saying. that the PAN card system has failed us. It has failed us not because of us, but because of bad governance. Why can't we revamp the whole PAN card system? Because it is what? Permanent account number for purposes of tax. Why can't we look at the whole system and redo the whole PAN card again instead of getting into the Aadhaar system? Because if there's a failure with regard to the systems of PAN, then there must be some system to rectify it. Why should we have it that because PAN has failed, so therefore use an alternate method, which in itself is contrary to the Act? The third part of it, you know, you are just doing a program on potholes. For every 100 meters, there is not a single road in India, excepting maybe a few, where you don't have a pothole every 50 yards. We are following the same thing for the purposes of e-governance in the matter of Aadhaar. Everything has a pothole somewhere or the other. It is really, I mean, one is at a loss to figure out why we are doing this, at what cost and to whose peril. You've just mentioned children, when they have got to go to schools, you got to mention an Aadhaar card. You got to take a ration, you got to mention an Aadhaar card. You got to take any license, you need the Aadhaar card. You need a death certificate, you need an Aadhaar card. I mean, the man is dead, why do you need an Aadhaar card for him? Isn't it lopsided? Isn't there someone to apply his mind as to what the Aadhaar should be? Or is it mandatory for everything? Just imagine the Northeast. Just imagine the tribal areas where they have no electricity, where they have no facilities to link up. Where in God's name are they going to get their Aadhaar cards? Where are the tribals going to go? Where are the poor people going to go? You have a population which is very largely under the below poverty line level. Are you going to compel them to get into this mess?
Yes.
Where are they going to turn around?
Before Gopal bhai,
you can say everything. I'm asking questions because these are questions which are disturbing us.
Can I just quickly add something?
One second, one at a time. Mr. Agarwal, respond to that and then Mohammed Khan can read.
I would like to just say this.
Yes.
One thing I would like to say is, Mr. Vasudev, is the government has mandated that the subsidy and schemes to the needy or has to come through this Aadhaar number, and that has been included in the Aadhaar Bill 2016. That the only thing government is required with regard to government schemes, benefits and subsidies. Second thing is, under the Income Tax Act, government has, Finance Ministry has issued notification, Mr. Agarwal, one minute. Bank account, you have to link your Aadhaar. These are the only two issues which the government has mandated.
Let me ask you a question.
Is a different thing. Yeah. It is not...
Mr. Agarwal, respond to what Thomas Franco said about the fact that the bankers have written to the Finance Ministry saying that this Aadhaar mandate is unconstitutional and should not be carried on. Mr. Agarwal, Thomas Franco just told us that the Bankers Association... Mr. Agarwal.
Restricting... Wait, let me finish. By 31st December, if the court does not restrict or close down this notification or some counter judgment, the government is within its power to implement these things. So I will advise people to link their bank account
or wait until the Supreme Court has given us a judgment.
Facing problems because the banks are going to freeze and deactivate their bank account.
Can I just say something to Mr. Agarwal very quickly? I want to say just one thing to him.
Understand the situation and advise people accordingly.
Mohammed Khan.
Don't advise people not to link their bank account with
Aadhaar. Mr.
Agarwal, you are making Aadhaar.
I want to say one thing to you. Gopal bhai, everything that you've said on this debate, everything you have said on this debate, every single statement you have made is undermined by the affidavit submitted by you in the Supreme Court, where you have argued for it to be made mandatory across the board. So when you're here saying that nahi, sirf do cheezon ke liye hai, you are contradicted by your own government stand in the Supreme Court. Agar aisi koi vivad nahi hai, agar ladai nahi hai, then please,
no,
there is no need to take the matter to the Supreme Court. You make this clear tomorrow and we will all withdraw our petitions.
Now, number two, and
I think we missed a larger point here where Gopal Krishna Agarwal said, before the 31st of December, yes, if the court doesn't shut this thing down,
yes,
then we can continue to make it mandatory. So why don't we wait until the court has its say? Why are we doing this? So that if the court shuts it down,
yes,
on the 31st of December or before that, you would have already collected an inordinate number of card numbers and data that will already be in the possession of these various agencies. That they will, you cannot then, once you have then knowledge, you cannot technically give it back.
When the government wants to act in a particular fashion.
So isn't it also fair, Gopal Krishna Agarwal, then, to tell viewers
that gives order on any issues, the government cannot act. It's an administrative decision.
To wait until the court gives its order.
There is some arcane government circular that he first spent the first half of the debate denying. Now he's saying, "Achha, theek
hai." Gentlemen, you are speaking at the same time.
The objective of the government. We will be successful in that.
It is very simple.
Okay. Hang on. Okay, I have one more question. One second. Mohammad Khan, just give me one second. I have one more question for Gopal Krishna Agarwal. Please respond to what Mr. Thomas Franco said, Mr. Agarwal, which you heard clearly. Mr. Agarwal, please respond to what Mr. Thomas Franco said very clearly.
He won't stop talking.
That the banking officers have written to the finance ministry and to the RBI and to the IBA saying this sort of collection of data is wrong and we must stop it because A, the bankers cannot be burdened with this extra duty and you can't right now ask for the Aadhaar to be linked to the bank accounts. What is your response to that? That the bankers themselves think this is a bad idea and should be stopped.
But KYC is the responsibility of the banks. Bank cannot write.
Show me the letter.
They might have said that this may be a complicated matter.
Aadhaar was even conceived.
Okay. You know, but to be fair, we will note that the banking industry, Thomas Franco, has already talked about how much KYC costs them. Whether it's mutual funds or insurance or banking, the cost of acquiring a customer is increased by the KYC. And if you keep increasing the needs of the KYC retrospectively right now.
Of other issues.
Thomas Franco, go ahead.
But every year,
KYC there are any other ways of getting the KYC done. It is not necessary that Aadhaar linkage has to be made compulsory for KYC norms. Even before Aadhaar came in, we had been having KYC norms which we had been following. That is not mandatory to have this linkage of Aadhaar for that. One. Number two, the finance minister himself has made a statement some time back that 4 crore population in this country who are eligible to open account, they could not even open the Jandan account because they are situated in interiors, in the red corridor, in the naxalite prone areas, because of which even the business correspondents could not reach them and the accounts could not be opened. And what happens to these people if they are not going to get any subsidy because they have not been able to get an Aadhaar card and they cannot link it to the bank? They are going to be at a loss. So this government should have a re-look on this and they should not make things so compulsory on the people.
What happened to the leakages in the subsidy? The manipulation.
Leakages can be arrested in many other ways.
But there's a difference between, Mr. Agarwal, there is a difference between plugging the leakages in the subsidies and starving little children to death. There is a difference between plugging the leakages in the subsidy and starving little children to death because you've cancelled their ration card. But I want to bring in Kailash Vasudev. I'm going to come back to the point that we're discussing, Mr. Vasudev. The fact that
I'm only talking,
Mr. Agarwal is telling us that unless the government, unless the court shuts this down, the government will continue until it has to stop.
No, I'm going to respond to that right away.
I'm talking of subsidies.
You look at it,
I'm not talking on subsidy case.
In view of the statements we have just received.
Mr. Vasudev is responding.
Agarwal,
one second.
May I come in for a minute, please?
One second, Mr. Vasudev is responding.
May I come in for a minute?
Go ahead, please. Go ahead, please.
You are making the. From what we are seeing right now, for everything, Aadhaar is being made mandatory. That is to say, if you don't have an Aadhaar number, you cannot get your licenses, you cannot get your ration, you cannot get your food, you cannot get your passport, you cannot get 10. Just a minute, Mr. Agarwal, please. We've been listening to you for a long time. Listen to us also. So in the absence of Aadhaar, you cannot get any of these things.
I told you.
May I ask you then?
Mobile, it has not mandated. LIC, it has not mandated. And still you are saying. Everything government is mandating.
Gopal bhai, people are being denied.
Mr. Agarwal, you are saying so. Government is saying something to the contrary.
Government by wrong statements.
No, I'm asking. No, Mr. Souza, I have a totally different take on this.
Mr. Agarwal, you have to let the other panelists speak because otherwise the audience cannot understand what is being said. I will come back to you to respond to what Mr. Vasudev is saying, but first we have to let him speak.
Stay for false facts.
Let him speak and then we'll come back to you and you can then refute whatever facts you think are false.
Everything. This is a false statement.
You see, now you're...
Mr. Vasudev.
No, as for the situation in which we are placed right now, for everything we need an Aadhaar. For everything we need an Aadhaar, even
this
for dying.
This is a false statement.
So, now therefore, for every activity of yours, now you look at it differently. So, therefore, in the absence of Aadhaar, you get nothing. You cannot have any, you cannot have title or ownership to anything whatsoever. In due property. Course of time, you will be linking Aadhaar to your properties and the RERA and so on and so forth.
In Delhi, it's already linked.
Yes, that's the RERA Act which has now come in. So for everything, you are going to be connecting the Aadhaar for everything. Then why do you need money laundering? Why do you need Banking Regulation Act? Why do you need the TRAI? Why do you need the IRDA? Get rid of all that and make Aadhaar the central theme of everything. Right. Because if everything is going to be Aadhaar-centric, the function of other authorities is going to be rendered useless. They're going to say, no Aadhaar, I'm sorry, I can't work. You want a telephone, I can't give it to you without an Aadhaar. You want an insurance policy, I can't. So why do you have the other acts? Get rid of them all, make everything Aadhaar-centralized. You see, you are making it a confiscatory act. You yes. cannot make it a confiscatory act. Confiscation penalties come under specific acts for specific purposes. Yes. Here, by way of the Aadhaar, you are making everything confiscatory. You won't have an Aadhaar card, you won't get this. I'm paying for it, you're not giving me charity. I'm taking my child to school, I'm paying for the fee. You're not giving me the subsidy. When I'm going to buy my stuff in the market, I'm paying for it. I'm declaring it against my PAN number. I'm giving it a payment by check. I mean, please tell us, where are we heading? You have a Supreme Court matter which is pending. You have a judgment of the High Court, of the Supreme Court, which has come on the Finance Act, which says, no, this is subject to the outcome of Supreme Court. Please understand, there has got to be some rational to the whole situation. You can't hold the whole citizens of this country up to a situation where, look, you don't do this, you won't get it. It's my money, it's my efforts. I pay my tax on it. I pay my GST on it. I pay all my duties on it. I buy an air ticket, I pay my duties on it. I buy a railway ticket, I pay my duties on it. It's nothing I'm not paying to the government. But then I'm held at ransom for everything else. I am sorry, I have serious reservations about the systems that you are following. Your PAN card is your failure. Your Aadhaar and the inclusions between 2012 and 14 are held to be bogus and fictitious for 50% of the people who have come in. Everything is bogus. Please put some rational sense into the workings.
I find, Mr.
You cannot hold the citizens to ransom for everything. A child dies, we have no sympathy for her.
Vasudev sahab, there are actually penal consequences because if you consider the fact that I have to link it to my PAN card, otherwise I can't file my income tax returns, then I am being bound. If I don't file my income tax returns, I will have criminal prosecution and penalties levied against me. And if I can't do that because I haven't been able to link it to Aadhaar, then they've effectively enforced penal consequences against me.
So I just want to make two points here. One is, of course...
I'm telling you have to link
it. Specific.
That is mandatory.
What is mandatory? Mr. Agarwal...
Linking your income tax return with Aadhaar is mandatory.
I don't know.
Linking is your bank account with Aadhaar by 31st December is required by the law. Other thing Mr. Vasudev is telling is a false and manipulating
simple solution
fact.
Debate.
They should
bahut
be checked by you and put on your website.
No. One second. Mohammed Khan, just give me a second, please. Yeah. Just one second, Mohammed Khan. Mr. Agarwal, as a representative of the BJP today on this show, on national television, you are telling me, other than my bank account, there is no need to link to anything else because nothing else is mandated by the government. No LIC,
and income tax return.
And income tax returns. Would you say that
income
clearly?
Income tax return and bank account.
Would you say that clearly so my audience can understand you? Say it again, please.
And other things are persuasive matters. Government wants it is under the Aadhaar
Act 2016
that clause 7 mandates the government schemes. Subsidies and
Mr. Agarwal, the government is trying to make it linked with the Aadhaar. Are you telling me
at
that
present,
telecom
they have not made it
Mr. Agarwal,
other thing
Mr. Agarwal,
that Mr. Vasudev is saying is all false.
Okay, so you're telling me that mobile phone companies have no authority and no mandate right now to ask for the Aadhaar details?
No, I'm sorry, I take exception to this. No, Mr. Souza,
I'm telling government has not mandated. No authority, I'm not telling.
Saying that my statements
are
false.
I'm telling government has not mandated that.
No, don't make these kind of statements which are false.
Sir, if I forge the government of India letterhead and start telling people that I'm acting on behalf of the government,
then you take action against those people. Why
these people are purporting to do this on your behalf and you haven't authorized them to do so?
Mr. Agarwal, I'm now going to say that you are making a false statement.
Please clarify on this debate. If you're saying it's not mandatory for bank accounts and cell phones,
then you're making a false statement.
Please make that clarification here.
No, sir. Then we see what Mr. Agarwal said. I'm making a false statement. I now say that you're making a false statement.
I have said what I have to say.
All right, I want to take this back to Thomas Franco. Thomas Franco works for the bank.
I'm also saying what I have to say.
Thomas Franco, I know that banks also sell mutual funds and insurance at this point. Mr. Agarwal, so you are telling me, right? You're telling me.
Very sad, Mr. Agarwal, to hear this from you.
You are telling me, Mr. Agarwal, that other than the banks, the Life Insurance Corporation of India, every single mutual fund company in the country, every single telecom company in the country, including Airtel, Vodafone, Reliance, Jio, all of these companies, every single insurance company in the country, the guys in the RTO in asking, you know, where we go to file our driver's license all over the country, all of the schools, they are all asking for our Aadhaar details completely illegally without any sort of mandate. And the government of India is just standing by and watching this?
No, I am telling government has not mandated. You don't manipulate my words. I am saying government has mandated only these two things. Other things are there, different regulatory authorities. They might have done.
They
are not
for privy this data,
to those
they claim
things.
It is on your
you
direction.
Get
the
into
message
those
says
things.
As
government
per the government of India directives.
Them.
The
if
message says
the insurance regulatory authority has given this regulation,
it, would not have
it
the
has to be seen in that
so,
light.
So if these regulators are not part of the government and establishment, what are they?
So you are...
Is the Department of Telecom not part of the telecom
if
ministry?
If the regulatory authority has given some orders, I don't know.
Mr. Franco, go ahead. Mr.
That,
Thomas
that has to be looked into. We have to investigate. We have to look into
the right arm
we have to go into that. But don't assume things that this has everything has been mandated by government. You are assuming everything.
No. So, Mr. Franco, help and my audience understand this. So, when something comes out of the RBI, the RBI, SEBI,
Mr. Agarwal, we are not assuming. Mr. Agarwal, you are putting the blame on the others. For the blame which has to come to the government, you are putting on the others. It is a false statement that no directives have been given by the government.
No, not
do you think that the banks are doing this without the directives of the bank? Is it without the directives of the government the banks are acting?
Bank
it is not
acting.
Correct. Let a senior official should not make false claims like this. It is the government which is forcing the banks. It is the government which is forcing the other organizations to inlink the Aadhaar. And they have come with this jam, Jandan Aadhaar mobile combination because of which they are making this claim. And you are making a statement as if the government has nothing to do with it and on their own banks are doing and others are doing. This is not correct. Please do not make this kind of statement.
Bank, I have said government has mandated. Don't, you have not
Sir,
heard me then. I am saying for bank and income tax
then on the
and some of
LIC
the schemes government
companies,
has directed
all these other
that Aadhaar will
asking for this card, why don't you issue a clarification? Why don't you say you'll take the strictest action against these people who, which I believe acting on behalf of the government in a misrepresentative capacity is a very serious offence, Gopal Bhai. Instead of saying we'll wait till the 31st,
the
please take action against them.
If the insurance authority has issued and direction, then
therein lies the rub. You keep saying that somebody has issued, you don't know who has issued. Sir, this is part of your large game to try and keep the people confused. Make an honest statement here. Make an honest statement and say, yes, our agenda is to carpet bomb everyone and make sure that everyone has an Aadhaar card, whether or not it's proven to be effective. And Gopal, do you know the problem with Aadhaar?
I just want to point out, one second. Mr. Agarwal, I just want to point out to you that if the regulation or if the directive has come, one second, Mr. Agarwal, If the regulation has come...
I'm telling you, if the SEBI has issued some directive, it is within its legal domain to issue that directive. It has nothing to do with the government. If the insurance regulatory authority has issued any directive, it is for the regulatory authority to answer.
The SEBI insurance... Mr. Agarwal, please, please, don't say things like this. We all know that SEBI, the IRDA and the RBI are part of the finance ministry. The Department of Telecom is part of the Ministry of Telecommunications. These are all part of the government. This is how the government is formed and this is how the government functions. So, are you telling me that SEBI will issue directions without consulting the finance ministry?
Why RBI has then said that we have not issued any directions?
Mr. Agarwal, so I'm reading
they
here.
Have clarified that.
Mr. Agarwal, Ministry of Finance has said, as per the Prevention of Money Laundering Act, in consultation with the RBI of India, because you have to consult with the RBI of India. So if SEBI is issuing a regulation, SEBI will consult with the Finance Ministry. IRDA will consult with the Finance Ministry. The Department of Telecom will consult with the Telecom Ministry. That is how it works.
Not on every issue.
How can you say these are not part of the government?
No, it doesn't consult on or issue. These regulatory authorities are independent authorities.
So you are telling me that these regulatory...
You don't know the structure there.
One second.
Regulatory authorities are independent
authorities.
They may
authorities. Be independent.
You have a very disturbing approach SEBI to governance,
is independent.
Mr. Agarwal.
Insurance authority. Why then otherwise there is a department of the government, it will function. Why
Mr.
you
Agarwal,
need a regulatory
Mr.
authority
Agarwal.
Then?
Mr. Agarwal.
These Agarwal. Are independent authorities.
Okay. No, I have to stop you there. Thomas Franco,
domain.
Do you want to clear this up for us? The difference between an independent regulator and a regulator that consults with the finance ministry and how the two of them are not
and
the same
department
thing.
All the regulatory authorities including Reserve Bank of India consult the finance ministry before taking any decision. There is nothing as independent regulatory authority. Let it be IRDA, let it be RBA, let it be SEBI. They do consult the finance ministry on taking decisions like this. I don't know how he can make a claim like this. He should own up the government. He is disowning the government itself.
No, he claims there are many pockets within this government and he can only speak
right.
for one and not the other.
Okay, I have two people who have been waiting on the phone line for a while. Kalpesh Shah has been on the phone line. Kalpesh, I apologize for keeping you holding for so long. Go ahead. Mr. Saraf, I can see your hand up. I'm coming to you as soon as we finish with this phone call. Kalpesh, go ahead.
Yeah, good evening, Fair.
Yes.
I really congratulate you for this channel because I have stopped watching all other channels because they all are under influence of somebody. But I always pray in the morning to the God that God gives you a lot of strength. How fantastic you are, you know, keeping all the facts in front of the citizens of India.
Thank you,
it's
sir.
Mind-blowing. I am so happy that I can't describe myself right now. Let me come back to Mr. Gopal Agarwal. Gopal bhai,
yes.
Ek aapko sawal karta hu main. I'm a businessman. मेरे भिवंडी में एक वेयरहाउस है और मेरा मुंबई में मेरा बिजनेस मैं करता हूँ. देना बैंक एक गवर्नमेंट रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बैंक है. मेरा एक बंदा यूपी से काम करने के लिए मेरे ऑफिस के स्टाफ ने उसको वहां पर रखा हुआ था. उसको एक बैंक अकाउंट खोलना था. मैं आपको दोनों एक्सट्रीम बताता हूँ मैं क्या हुआ है. ये आधार है ना, अनाधार हो गया है. ये पैनलिस्ट ने प्रूव कर दिया है और अभी मैं प्रूव करूंगा आपको. देखिए, ये जब भी वो बंदा अपने आप गया देना बैंक में तो उसको ये आधार का लवली कार्ड बताया गया कि आप आधार होगा तो ही बनाया जाएगा. तो वो बेचारा, उसके पास आधार था नहीं, तो मेरे चीफ अकाउंटेंट से पास आके बोला कि ये मेरा हो नहीं सकता है, अभी मुझे तो चेक पेमेंट ही करना है उसको. 10,000 की तनख्वाह मैंने नक्की की हुई थी तो मेरे पास आया. देन यू नो आई कॉल्ड अप द बैंक मैनेजर. आई हैव अ वेरी बिग सीसी लिमिट. आई हैव अ 30 crore टर्नओवर. दो आई एम अ स्मॉल बट आई एम डूइंग नाइस बिजनेस. बैंक मैनेजर ने मुझे पूछा, कल्पेश भाई कायदा कानून फलाना फलाना बोला. मैंने बोला कर रहा है नहीं कर रहा है, ये मेरा बंदा है, आधार नहीं मिलेगा, अकाउंट ओपन होगा या नहीं होगा, वरना फिर मैं मेरा बैंक अकाउंट दूसरी जगह दूसरी बैंक में लेके जाता हूँ. इमीजिएटली विदाउट सेइंग एनीथिंग, कहाँ गया आपका कायदा कानून? हाँ, कहाँ गया आपका कायदा कानून साहब, बताओ. उसने खोल दिया अकाउंट. ये एक एक्सट्रीम. दूसरा एक्सट्रीम, I have a customer, Trident, in Punjab. It's a very big company. Yeah. आपको पता है, it's a private organization, limited company है, शेयर बाजार में listed है. उसने सभी vendor को आधार कार्ड के लिए compulsory किया. Only I am the exception who refused to, you know, give my आधार कार्ड. क्यों भाई? आपका ये पिताजी का मामला है क्या? It's a private limited company, मुझे देना है दू, नहीं देना है नहीं दू. आपको तो मुझे क्या बताया जाता है? ये बीजेपी की गवर्नमेंट है, ये कुछ भी कर सकती है। इनकम टैक्स में हम लोग ऑलरेडी हैरान हो चुके हैं। ये कायदा बनाते हैं एसी कैबिन में बैठ के, और जब इम्प्लीमेंटेशन के टाइम पे उनके जो एम्प्लॉइज जो होते हैं विच आर नॉट रिक्रूटेड, विच आर नॉट प्रॉपरली गाइडेड, वो कुछ भी कायदा चला लेते हैं और खाली एक ही शब्द बोलते हैं, हमें ऊपर से ऑर्डर है, आप इनकम टैक्स में अपील में जाओ, आप ट्रिब्यूनल में जाओ, आप हाई कोर्ट में जाओ, आप पैसा भरो, पैसा भरो, हर एक चीज के ऊपर पैसा भरो। भाई साहब आप नहीं मानेंगे, मुझे वेंडर से डी रजिस्टर किया गया, जो मैं बिजनेस वो कंपनी में 7 साल से कर रहा हूँ, बिकॉज ऑफ जस्ट आधार कार्ड। ये आपका आधार की अनाधार कार्ड की मैं आपको विपदा बता रहा हूँ, बोलो कुछ है। दूसरी बात, पैनलिस्ट ने जो अभी बताया हुआ है, आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू मिस्टर मोहम्मद खान, मिस्टर कैलाश वासुदेव एंड जो फॉर्मर CIO जो बैठे हुए, उन्होंने बहुत सारी चीज, यू हैव रियली सिलेक्टेड द बेस्ट ऑफ द पैनलिस्ट फॉर इन दिस फोरम, दिस इज एक्सलेंट। एंड उन्होंने जो ये पैन कार्ड का और आधार कार्ड का जो फैक्ट्स अपने सामने रखी हुई है, पैन कार्ड और आधार कार्ड के ऑडिट नहीं आई है, शर्म आनी चाहिए गोपाल भाई, शर्म आनी चाहिए बीजेपी को।
ओके ओके ओके, अमरजीत गुप्ता ऑन द फोन लाइन फ्रॉम दिल्ली, मिस्टर गुप्ता गो अहेड।
ओके थैंक यू फ्रे, यू नो कांग्रेचुलेशंस अगेन फॉर दिस ग्रेट प्रोग्राम। सो आई जस्ट वांट टू, माय क्वेश्चन एंड माय फीडबैक इज टू गोपाल अग्रवाल। गोपाल भाई, द इंटेंट ऑफ द आधार प्रोग्राम इज वेल अंडरस्टूड, I myself come from the IT industry, I understand that. But I can tell you on the ground, it's misimplemented like anything. My niece, by the way, happens to be domiciled Assam. And I don't know how many of the panelists know, in Assam, till date, there is not a single Aadhaar card issued because there's the National Registry for Citizens which is getting updated.
Yes.
She called me up frantically because she's got a job in Jaipur on 1st, and the private organization has asked her for an Aadhaar card. And of course, I'll find a way for her to create one in Delhi. But is that the way you want to implement Aadhaar on 21-year-old future Indian nationals, Mr. Agarwal? Is that the chaotic way in which you will implement Aadhaar? That's my question for you.
Right. I'm going to go to Anupam Saraf, who also had a point to make, and then we can respond to the callers. Mr. Saraf, go ahead.
Yeah, I have a question for Mr. Agarwal. He has been constantly saying that the government has not issued any mandate and it is private parties who are actually claiming the Aadhaar illegally. Ultimately, is the UIDAI not a government agency? The UIDAI has already been told by the Supreme Court, by a 5-member bench of the Supreme Court, that the Aadhaar has to be restricted to only 5 schemes, and that too on a voluntary basis. How is it that the UIDAI has been making available the data of the Aadhaar to anybody besides these 5 schemes? Can you explain, Mr. Agarwal? Is it not the responsibility of the UIDAI to show that it abides to the laws of the land? Is it not the responsibility of the UIDAI to ensure that it does not create contempt of the Supreme Court of India? Is it not the responsibility of the UIDAI to make sure that private parties do not get access to the Aadhaar data? Is it not the responsibility of the UIDAI to ensure it issues no notifications to banks threatening them?
Yes.
That if you do not ask
and
your
is
customers
it, yeah,
for Aadhaar.
Absolutely, Mr. Saraf, you've made an excellent point. Is it not the responsibility of the UIDAI and the government to make sure that they don't, you know, ask for data that has not been mandated? If it's not been mandated by anybody, what gives private companies the authority to ask for your Aadhaar data? Like the caller had just told us that someone he was doing business with mandated it. But I just want to point out one thing, Mr. Agarwal. If I'm not mistaken, Mr. Agarwal said that other than IT returns and bank accounts, which are mandated and compulsory by the government, nothing else is mandated and compulsory by the government. But not long ago, we did a show, a discussion on this very show, where we had Arvind Gupta of the BJP who told us something else altogether. And I just want to play that out because we have that on record. Can we play that out, please? So my question is, Mr. Arvind Gupta, for my viewers who are watching right now, is it mandatory for us to link Aadhaar to our phone numbers and our bank accounts?
The easy answer to that lies is, given the last judgment and until a new judgment comes, in my opinion, and I'm not a legal expert, in my opinion,
but it's a yes or no answer.
Said that you need to do that, and unless there's a it's a very simple answer I'm giving that. In my my assessment, the current directive of the Supreme Court, the two bench court holds, and which is saying that you have to link them. And that is what the process the telecom companies are following.
Mr. Agarwal, isn't there a great deal of confusion right now, even within the government, about what is compulsory and what is not anymore?
No, he is also saying about the bank account only. That's
no,
what
no, I asked him about the telephone. No, I asked him about the telephone. I asked him about the
bank
telephone
account. I'm saying
well.
That government has mandated.
Telephone
income
connections?
Income tax return, it has mandated. And on some of the schemes.
Telephone
it
connections?
It is voluntary, but government is pursuing that if you link, it is better. On the subsidies and the benefits.
Telephone connections, Mr. Agarwal?
Might have been done by those regulatory authority, but the government has not mandated.
Telephone
can
connections?
Can I say one sentence?
LIC policy? Mutual funds? Insurance policies?
That you have to check with those regulatory authority whether they have done it on their own or I don't know.
Are they allowed to do it on their own?
If that has come, that has come from those regulatory authorities.
The damage already seems to have been done.
Second thing,
no, I'm just going to give the last word. I'm going to give the last word. Last word to Kailash Vasudev. Mr. Vasudev, there is an Aadhaar Act that mandates what the UIDAI will do. And if the government wants us to believe that this particular data is sacrosanct, how is it allowing anybody to make rules and saying, I've decided I also want your Aadhaar card. I also want your Aadhaar card. Tomorrow I will tell all the reporters that if you want to file a story on Mirror Now, I want your Aadhaar number first.
Only Aadhaar
so which means
number,
that anybody can decide. So how is this data sacrosanct anymore?
That's right.
Only Aadhaar number, UDI authorities not sharing the information with those agencies.
Iska jawab kaise de,
Gopal? It is only verifying the Aadhaar number, the identity.
But how do you verify if you don't have access to the database?
For checking. They are not sharing the fingerprints with the agencies. It is not, they are not giving access to the fingerprints.
We are.
Only number is given. When you put that number, they will check the identity and respond.
Okay. So, okay, unfortunately,
Mr. Agarwal,
that is not
Mr.
permitted.
Mr. Agarwal, just 1 minute. Mr. Agarwal, just 1 minute.
They are not giving that you check the
fingerprints
this is
not permitted, but let me tell you what happens.
Him.
Are you really listen for a minute? Please listen to me for a minute. You go to Airtel or you go to any of these companies, they will put a machine before you with your thumb impression.
Yeah.
You hit it, only then the UDI appears. The unique identity appears the moment you hit that machine of theirs. They say, yes, now, sir, you are linked to your Aadhaar. How did they get that? It flew in from some other place.
Yes.
Without stamp, without your fingerprints on the machine, your Aadhaar card is not linked. How do they get it? It is a core information on biometrics. How do these private telephone companies get it?
Correct.
Either you accept the fact that I give a copy of my Aadhaar card for the purposes of linking, but why should I give my fingerprints and thumb impression? They're called biometrics under the Act. Why must they ask for it?
Absolutely. Why must they? And I have to wrap up this conversation because we've run out of time. Gentlemen, I thank you. I thank you for your time. And especially Thomas Franco, who made time today at a last minute phone call. I appreciate all of you for coming in. We're going to have more conversations because our audience is still confused. This is the fifth conversation we have had on whether or not it's mandatory. And people still do not know the answer. And I think that is really unfortunate. But from what we understand, from the fact that Mr. Vasudev is an expert lawyer, and we have Anupam Saraf, who is an expert at IT, we have a banker on board, it seems like for as long as the Supreme Court does not mandate it, and we have to wait till the Supreme Court gives us its judgment, it's not compulsory. It's not compulsory. Because nobody, no government, no RBI, and the RBI said it hasn't done it, and no bank has the authority to either freeze your account or deactivate your account because it's your money and it's your account. And the government does not have the right to assume that we are all guilty until we are proven innocent, which means that if you're not sharing your Aadhaar, there must be something suspicious in your account. That is not how the law works in this country. So if you get a phone call from your insurance company, from your mutual fund company, from your telephone company, or from your bank saying, nay, nay, mandatory, yes, sir, deactivate ho jayega, please tell them, look up what's happening in the Supreme Court. This matter is sub judice, and until the Supreme Court gives its decision, I am not linking anything to anything. Thank you. goodbye. It is, you are within your rights to do so. It is not compulsory. If you want to do so, if you're more comfortable doing so, please go ahead and do so. But if you don't want to, nobody can force you. We're going to stay on this story until there is an answer, because right now it is obvious there isn't one. Thanks for watching.